guys, I figured I'd make a final video on this emachines laptop that I repaired the other day. It is finished. Okay, so where would I start? First I found out it had no power, then I found out it had a bad power jack. Then I found the traces in the board around the power jack were damaged from heat and over soldering. So I bypassed that. I found, following the traces on the board, that some of the FETs were bridged with solder, so I unsoldered them. Probably when the previous tech was trying to repair it. He actually did label it on the board that no power, and then the date that he tried to fix it. That I'll leave on the corner there, you can see it. Then after all that, when I finally did get it to turn on, it would cycle. And then I found that it was one of these bias batteries were bad, and they're not really serviceable, by the way. So, you know, once they go bad, I guess the emachines are pretty much garbage. So, it's working now. I basically put a jack like this on it because the board was in such rough shape, there's no way I can get anything on it. These work pretty good. You can pull them out of the way, and this laptop is great for, like, if you have kids, because if they pull it, it'll just pop out versus damage the plug. See? So that's why I put it there. Be a spare for the kids. I threw a board in it. I mean, I threw a hard drive in it just for a test. I got a key that I'm going to glue in there. Oh wait, I want to show you the... I turned off. I want to show you the specs. To it. There we go. AMD Athlon processor TF20 at 1600 megahertz. There ain't much in the way of settings, that's for sure. 512 of RAM, 64 of memory. That's about it. Gives you the boot order, and that's about it. Pretty basic machine for, well, obviously it's the emachines. But it's actually pretty preppy for an Athlon. No, started normally. Yeah, I basically just threw the drive in just to test it. Basically put the lid on it and put all the parts back in the hard drive tray and throw it on the rack for storage. Once I glue a button on there. It's better than scrap, I guess. But as you can see, it works fine. The sound works good. I wouldn't say it's the loudest, but it works. Yeah, now it takes forever. There it goes. Trackpad works. Mouse pad. Everything works there. Everything in Windows 7 is plug and play. The sound was plug and play. I believe the network card is plug and play as well. I'll give it a minute to boot up. There it is. So that's also plug and play. And it's working. So I feel sorry for the previous tech that was working on it, because he must have been going through hell trying to get this thing to work. There are so many problems with it. But it works fine now. Check the drive. Drive works good. I've already tested it with the XP CD. It fired right up. Good as a spare. Later, guys.